Two Gen Gamers Dumb Drive.
Now, this one's one of the bloodier games on the console.
And, surprisingly, not one of the ones the ESRB rating system went after. Although, it seems like the titles they went after were American titles. This, being from Namco, is not an American title.
And but rise from your grave.
Definitely has an American-type theme, very similar to Jason, the horror protagonist from the
Friday the 13th movies.
Yes, thank you. Ray is our
horror movie excerpt.
Yes, Ray knows his horror movies. I only dabble.
Yeah, I'm a big horror movie fan.
And the Splatterhouse series was big on Genesis, and another one that would not have been allowed on Nintendo's systems.
Oh,
and,
no.
And showed off the kind of edginess that Sega was pushing. And again, this is another side-scrolling beat-em-up, and the Sega Genesis was
huge for these.
Yeah, that was probably one of their biggest genres and that we saw the most of.
Yeah, the side-scrolling beat-em-up was essentially half of the Genesis's library.
So you gotta find creative and inventive ways to recreate that, and so here's a take that Namco had on it.
A bloody take. Yeah, everything's gooey in this game. I guess the whole splatter house thing.
Yeah, they really do come through with the name on this one. Everything, you know, you see, you hit those guys, they splatter up against the wall. You splatter this guy and that guy with your punches. It's over the top, that's for sure.
Yeah, for a horror-type game, it's one of the few early on that got it.
And your character is obviously some sort of crazy maniac.
Murderer-type psychopath or something.
And he has no shoes on, and that, I think, just shows how crazy he is. You know, when you're fighting specters and demons and not wearing shoes, you're out there, man.
Yeah, there's something wrong.
And as we watch them dance around here, our protagonist comes in and kills them.
Uh-oh.
Oh!
Now we have a giant, ugly boss who just belched acid on me and I died.
Yes, he's very hut-like.
Yeah. Good thing you can trap him in a corner.
Aww. Except when he expels the contents of his bowel onto you.
Oh, that sucked. Yeah, you have basically like that skull type face.
Yeah, so this is just a very creepy,
dark
game.
This was the one that if your mom saw you playing it, she'd freak out and burn it and say you're going to hell. Say you're going to church. That's it.
Which
we're going to church this weekend.
Which is the bane of all young men's existence.
Yeah, if you were at home with a Sega Genesis and your mom said you're going to church, you might as well forget having that game anymore. She went and burned it in the backyard somewhere. All right.
And another.
Well, this is a good look at Splatterhouse.
Yeah, another thing you see with this is that the levels kind of differ. It's not just you know, beat 'em up, run through the level, but it's very ambient. You see here, it's dark. Great atmosphere on this series, so if you want to check out a great old beat-em-up, check this out. There you see those skulls in the background appearing just to mess with you. I mean, this is very dark and disturbing, so.
And of course you get death spikes.
If you like the macabre, check it out.
Yeah, definitely. Now we're going to take a look at one of the last games released on the Sega Genesis, World Series Baseball 98. This was right before they pulled the plug on the system.
Yeah, and this really showed off the power of the Genesis. We've kind of been going through and looking at the evolution of the system here, and this really shows kind of the end of the life cycle and where things got development-wise, and what could be done with the system when it was pushed to its limits, and the next title we look at will as well. So we're wrapping it up here, and as you can see, this has awesome graphics for a 16-bit system.
Now, I always love the World Series Baseball Series because you can select where you're pitching. See the box there? You can select the type of hit you do. There's normal, contact, and power hitting. See, I did a power hit there, and yeah, he nailed it all the way out to the outfield there.
Yeah, this is leagues above most of the other baseball games that we saw around the time. Again, the SNES Genesis rivalry, Nintendo had their Ken Griffey Jr. series because they owned the Seattle Mariners. But I don't think the series could quite hold up to this one. This is really well put together. But again,
they threw in some voice work, too.
Yeah, but again, by the time this came out, the Genesis was pretty much dead. And that's another thing. Sega's sports games did feature a lot of voice work, and all of the Genesis games featured a lot more actual voice work than we heard on the Super Nintendo.
I wonder why that was, because the Super Nintendo, as most people believe, had the superior sound chip.
Well, it was better at emulating real-world sounds. So if you'll notice, a lot of epic Super Nintendo games have like really good wind sounds and things of that sort, environmental sounds.
Yeah.
Because that's what that sound chip was programmed to do, where the Genesis was a lot better at this voice work. So again, there you see the contrasting and comparison of the systems, which was relentless during that time. I mean, they were so similar, and both had so many great titles. You had to pick out things that made one better than the other.
Yeah, that's why this console war was really so close, was just the fact that the systems were so similar that it was kind of hard to distinguish them, and both had really great games.
And even the TurboGrafx, which we didn't see as much of it in America, but it held up in Japan and did well under, well, we call it the PC Engine. That's what they call it, but it was the same technology, same machine.
Yeah. And so Sega really tried with their Genesis, and they did a good job. And they attempted to keep the console alive as long as they possibly could, which we've kind of gone into a little bit, and we'll definitely show you how they attempted to do that in some of the later ones.
Even though they essentially killed the Genesis and every other existing line several times, but titles would keep eking out like this because people still had Genesises.
Genesis?
They had Genesi.
Genesi. That almost sounds bad.
So, this is an awesome baseball game of the era. So, this kind of winds out the look at all these great sports games for the Genesis. So, let's take a look at one more Sonic game to round out the Genesis lineup.
Genesis. I heard Matt got a Sega Genesis.
Well, I guess one more is okay.
The Sega Genesis. Game cartridges sold separately.
Game Gamers.